The army and the police sealed off the headquarters of Uganda's biggest opposition party this morning in what they called a precautionary move ahead of planned anti-government protests tomorrow. On Saturday, police said they had informed the organizers of tomorrow's march that it wasn't permitted. The march was organized on social media by youth dubbed hashtag Stop Corruption. While addressing journalists at the police headquarters, police spokesperson Kituma Rusoke said despite efforts to persuade the organizers to drop the march, they persisted. He added that the force was seeking to stop them from taking this decision. Robert Kyagulanyi, the new party president, said that security forces raided the party headquarters and made some arrests. He, however, denied allegations that his party organized the protest.
I wouldn't want anybody to target on me. Like I said, I support them 100%. But there comes a time even when people must lead from the front or from the back. This time young people are leading from the front.
On Saturday, President Yoweri Museveni cautioned against protests, saying protesters are playing with fire.
Now when you hear people talking of demonstrations, what? When you demonstrate in a place like Kampala, people are sitting on the roadside. Are you going to step in people's products? You are playing. Do not have such ideas in your head.
Youth have been using social media to demand an end to corruption. Museveni has already repeatedly cautioned against it, saying whenever there is sufficient evidence, culprits will be prosecuted. The Forum for Democratic Change Katonga faction has concluded its consultations at their headquarters. This marks the climax of the drive across the 20 regions according to the party constitution. Erias Lukwago, the faction's president, said that they are in the final stages of compiling the proposals submitted by their supporters and will publish the findings in the delegates' conference.
We shall have time to recount what we have gone through as NEC. We are preparing the final leg of the journey and we are just on the final touches, tying the loose ends to prepare for a report that will be submitted to the National Delegates Conference, where a decision has to be taken one way or the other.
Betty Ochan, the Guluman Member of Parliament, called on supporters to stay united in the struggle for good leadership.
So let us keep strong. Something which you get for today, if you don't plan strategically, can derail us. Young people, this country is ours. We are going nowhere.
In March, the faction led by Lukwago embarked on nationwide consultative meetings to chart a way forward after they broke away from Najana Nkumbi. Ambassador Waswabirigwa, the FDC Katonga National Chairperson, said delegates will meet on August 2nd to determine the way forward. He said that all resolutions from the regions will be presented and the majority will decide on whether to form a new political party or not. After West Nile, the Green School evaluators and assessors have moved to northern Uganda. Here, they evaluated how schools are addressing climate change. Under the theme, Climate Change, Innovations That Work, schools are developing innovations to mitigate and combat climate change. The Green School Initiative is focused on fighting climate change by sensitizing the young generation. Six schools, including Onono Memorial College, YY Okot Memorial College, Lango College, Komboni College, Anguringiri Girls Secondary School, and Alemere Secondary School were evaluated to determine which would be rewarded for their innovations and efforts in combating climate change in the region. Forest and tree nursery beds, energy-saving stoves, incinerators, bottle recycling, and various environment and climate change clubs are among the innovations introduced in different schools to help sensitize and combat climate change.
Having the garden here as an environmental club garden, it really helps us. First of all, we are specifying things like using fertilizers and pesticides. These are things that really affect even the soil.
Right now, the main thing we have to do to fight climate change is clear sensitizations. Not only that, we can also bring in the issue of recycling industries.
We're coming out with eco-friendly charcoal stove that can use only the maize remain and then also the rice acts remain.
The evaluators also shared their assessments of the schools they visited. After Northern Uganda, the team will head to Midwest.
We have found learners to be very enthusiastic. Some are coming up with prototypes of making, for instance, dustbins that have sensors in them, such that when I approach it, it's able to detect and it opens automatically.
The initiative is organized by Vision Group with support from the Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations and sponsored by the Embassy of Sweden.